Carrying an awl into the field is a great tool. It's a great resource for not only repairing items, but getting work done around camp. I carry an awl all the time in my haversack. Actually, it's this awl right here. It's small, it doesn't take up much room, and it's just there when I need it. Now, an awl will never replace a needle, and a needle will never replace an awl. Although they'll work somewhat together, they're two separate entities in my mind, and an awl can do a lot more than a needle will ever do as far as punching holes and doing heavy work. So I personally like to carry an awl with me, but there's several different style awls that you can carry. They can be different sizes and different shapes. I want to show you that now so you have a better understanding of why we would use awls in different situations. The easiest way I found to find a good awl is to go out to a junk store, go out to a flea market or a yard sale and find an ice pick. Cut the ice pick short, sharpen up the edge. That's what I did here. I use this awl all the time. It's a great, great awl. If you don't want it this length, you can even cut the handle down and have a little push awl. It works really well. Another option that you can do is keep the ice pick long and just cut the metal section off, discard the handle, and then you can make something that looks like this. Just put your own handle on. There's a variety of different handles you can use. I chose a small piece of antler that I had. I drilled it out and epoxied this in, and then I have something that looks just a little bit more woodsy and traditional. Now, both designs like this are round awls, meaning that the base of these are round and they just come to a point. Round awls are great. It's probably where you want to start if you're going to just start carrying an awl. But there's also another style awl, which is a three-sided awl, very similar to this one. This has, of course, three sides. Each edge is somewhat sharp. They're not razor sharp, but they're sharp and it comes to a point. A three-sided awl is a great crafting tool. The big difference between a round and three-sided awl is in the cutting action of the awl itself. Let's think of fibers and think about this round awl. When we push this into any type of fiber, it normally just spreads the fibers open more. So wherever that hole is going to be, it spreads that hole open and allows the awl to slide through, creating a hole. If we think about natural materials, once we create that hole and we pull that awl back out, it already starts to shrink back up on itself, or if it gets wet and then dries, it's going to shrink back down. So a round awl is great for that type of use. A three-sided awl, on the other hand, has more of a cutting effect. So if we think about them fibers again and we think about sliding this in, as this triangle goes through those fibers, it normally cuts some of that fiber, actually breaking the fiber open. If we give it a quick turn, it acts like a drill and actually cuts those fibers, leaving a bigger hole that's not going to shrink and close down on itself. So depending on what type of project you're doing, depends on what type of awl you would want. So it's something to think about. Maybe throw an awl in your kit, maybe throw two awls in your kit. It depends on what you're actually going to be doing, but I can say that I carry one all the time and it works out great for me. I use it a lot more than you would even think I do. So this was Dan Wowak with Coalcracker Bushcraft. As always, check us out at coalcrackerbushcraft.com, and until the next video, stay in the woods.